A forensic pathologist sounding the alarm over the rising number of inmates dying due to tuberculosis in the new Bilibid prison. Dr. Raquel Fortun says the prevalence of tuberculosis in enclosed spaces such as prisons poses a risk to all the people within the vicinity. Corrections Chief Gregorio Katapang notes the decongestion of the new Bilibid prison may address these health concerns. This comes as rights groups call on the Human Rights Commission to lobby for the release of elderly and terminally ill political prisoners. One group says of the 754 political prisoners in the country, 90 are elderly and 102 are facing illnesses that need critical medical attention.
The Philippine Investment Board gives its stamp of approval to agricultural projects worth 9.59 billion pesos in the first half of the year. The BOI said this is a result of its partnership with the Agriculture Department to strengthen the country's food security. Among the projects are two facilities of Metro Pacific Dairy Farms in Laguna and Bulacan that are capable of producing more than 9 million liters of dairy and plant-based beverage and over 1,600 tons of vegetables annually. The projects are part of the BOI's push to position the Philippines as a regional hub for globally competitive and sustainability-driven industries. 66 Chinese military aircraft surround the island of Taiwan a day after Beijing held exercises in nearby waters. Taiwan's Defense Ministry says 56 of the aircraft crossed the sensitive median line, splitting the Taiwan Strait. Japan's Defense Ministry, meanwhile, released photos of China's aircraft carrier Shandong off the sea of the Okinawa Prefecture. Over 30 Chinese military aircraft also flew south of the island to carry out drills with the Shandong.
In entertainment, Hollywood actor Alec Baldwin faces the court for his manslaughter trial in New Mexico. Baldwin is charged for the 2021 killing of cinematographer Helena Hutchins during the filming of the movie Rust. In their opening statements, prosecutors accused Baldwin of breaking gun rules when he accidentally shot Hutchins during rehearsal. But defense lawyers argue the set's armorer and first assistant director, both of whom were convicted of involuntary manslaughter, were responsible for firearm safety. The incident is Hollywood's first on-set shooting fatality in three decades. Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez believes it is Duterte's prerogative not to attend the sauna, but Filipinos deserve to see their leaders united and focused on their welfare. He calls the sauna a crucial moment for officials to put a united front and address the challenges the country is facing. But for House lawmaker Joel Chua, Duterte's jokes about the president's security is a joke made in poor taste given current political tensions. He adds Duterte does not have the power to appoint herself as a designated survivor since the succession line is enshrined in the 1987 Constitution. Duterte earlier referenced the American series Designated Survivor, which follows a low-ranking cabinet member who took over the White House after everyone in the presidential succession line was killed in a mass casualty event. As for the House Secretary General, Reginald Velasco, his office will confirm with the office of the Vice President whether Duterte will skip Marcos's sauna. He also sees Duterte's reference to designated survivor as a joke.
Ako personally, kasi alam mo yung pamilya ni BP, mapagbiro eh. So, ang tingin ko, biro lang yun eh. Because under our laws, wala, or our constitution, the succession is already provided for in the constitution. So there's no such thing as designated survivor. So kailangan magkaroon talaga tayo ng batas na gano'n. At tapos baka kailangan ilagay sa constitution yun. That means we have to amend the constitution.
Meanwhile, former lawmaker Nery Colmenares sees Duterte's non-attendance as a sign of her complete breakaway from the administration's unit team alliance.
While it is the choice of the vice president to attend or not attend the sauna, maraming mensahe yon. Yung isang mensahe doon, para sa akin, ha, hindi siya naniniwala sa i-report ng presidente sa SONA. At may disagreement siya doon sa mga i-claim na achievement ng Marcos administration. And secondly, complete break na yon sa anumang alyansang karoon sila.